I've been looking for a method to classify elements. All right? And in 1829, the German scientist, his name is Dobernier, German scientist, we'll call chemist. His name is J.W. Dobernier. He observed several elements. And classified into three groups. Three groups, and he called them triads. He said he called them triads. TRIAD, TRIADS, triads. So that's the first discovery.
What is that word?
TRIADS. So in that triads, all three elements. They showed very similar chemical properties. So that's observation. Then Newland came and he suggested 62 elements. I'm going to write that in the next slide. In 1865, A.R. Newland suggested that the 62 known elements be arranged into groups of seven. And that arrangement is according to increasing atomic mass. Increasing atomic mass. And his theory was called the law of octaves. Law of octaves. O-C-T-A-V-E-S. Okay.
you call it octaves if it was in the groups of seven?
And he actually, seven kind of groups, and then he came up with, his theory is called law of octaves. That's what Book is saying.
Okay.
It says that.
Then after he proposed eight elements.
Yeah.
So I'm going to go over with that one.
Okay.
So he proposed that an eighth element would repeat the properties of the first in the group. So maybe that's why he come up, since it's eighth element, that's why he said law of octave. Because eighth elements, that's how they, you know, repeat the properties. And that's how they, he gave law of octaves. And his theory was not accepted widely at that time. So, theory was not widely accepted. For about 20 years. Even though it was mostly correct. So then after Mendeleev came and he proposed, so we are going to look for Mendeleev's theory. Okay. So that's early discovery.